Okay, so let us solve the problems on trigonometric equations. The first problem, solve sin x is equal to 1 by root 2. So that means how to solve this problem? The whose value of sin is equal to 1 by root 2? Yes, we know that sin 45 degrees or sin of pi by 4. So that means here pi by 4 is the principal value. So, whereas principal value means alpha is equal to pi by 4. If alpha is equal to pi by 4, what is the general solution of sin theta is equal to sin k, or sorry, sin theta is equal to sin alpha? We know that theta is equal to n pi plus or minus minus 1 to the power of n alpha. So, that means here alpha is equal to pi by 4, just replace alpha per pi by 4. So that will be the general solution of this equation. So suppose if you are asked to solve this, sin x is equal to 1 by root 2 means, here we have to find out the general solution of the sin x is equal to 1 by root 2. That means the possible solutions of sin x is equal to 1 by root 2, we have to find out. Otherwise, in particular, you are asked to find out the principal solution of sin x is equal to 1 by root 2, then the answer will be quite, it is obvious that is pi by 4, or in some stipulated interval is there, in that interval means first you write down the general solution. So in that stipulated interview, you have to substitute n values for the integer values we get. We have to pick up those values which lies in the given interval. So these kind of strategies are to be followed to solve the trigonometric equations. So let us solve this problem, sin x is equal to 1 by root 2. So now here, it's given sin x equals to 1 by root 2. So now we can write sin x is equal to sin pi by 4. Here alpha is equal to principal value pi by 4. Now the general solution is, here x equals to n pi plus or minus minus 1 to the power of n alpha. So now this is equal to n pi plus or minus minus 1 to the power of n pi by 4, where here n belongs to integers. So this is the answer for this one. So let us solve the second example. Sin 2 theta is equal to root 5 minus 1 by 4. Here root 5 minus 1 by 4 stands for sin 18 degrees. 18 degrees is equivalent to pi by 10 radians. So that means the sin 2 theta is equal to, we can write sin of pi by 10, where pi by 10 is the principal value. So now here, one thing you must remember, the pi by 10 is the principal value of 2 theta. You should not write the principal value for 2 theta is equal to pi by 10 and theta is equal to pi by 20. Directly write down the principal value as pi by 10 only, not pi by 20. Please remember this one. This is very important while solving these type of the problems. So after getting the principal value, so it is in the form of sin 2 theta is equal to k or sin alpha. The general solution is given by 2 theta is equal to n pi plus or minus minus 1 to the power of into alpha. So if you want to simplify, then you can simplify it. Divide root by 2, you get theta, that will be the general solution. So let us solve it. So now this problem can be solved like this. Given sin 2 theta equals to root 5 minus 1 by 4. Now sin 2 theta equals to sin 18 degrees, which is equivalent to sin of pi by 10 radians. Here alpha is equal to principal value, which is pi by 10. Now the general solution is 2 theta equals to n pi plus minus 1 to the power of n alpha. Just replace alpha. N pi plus minus 1 to the power of n pi by 10. Multiply 1 by 2 on both sides. So, therefore, we get theta is equal to n pi by 2 plus minus 1 to the power of n pi by 20. N belongs to z. So, this is the general solution. So, let us solve one more problem. Solve tan square theta is equal to 3. Tan square theta is equal to 3 means 3 can be written root 3 whole square. Root 3 is equivalent to tan of 60 degrees, tan of pi by 3. So that means tan square theta is equal to tan square pi by 3, where pi by 3 is the actually one of the principal values, or principal value is equal to plus or minus pi by 3 also you can write it, alpha is equal to, but directly principal value is alpha is equal to pi by 3. Now, it is as it is in the form of tan square theta is equal to tan square alpha, we can write n pi plus or minus alpha. So, this procedure is to be adopted to solve this problem. Now, given tan square theta is equal to 3, which can be written root 3 whole square. This is tan square pi by 3. Alpha is equal to principal value, that is pi by 3. General solution is theta is equal to n pi plus or minus alpha. So, n pi plus or minus pi by 3. Here, n belongs to integers. So, let us solve one more problem. Solve 3 cosecant x is equal to 4 sin x. Here, we have cosecant x. We had a already discussion. Whenever cosecant x appears, it should be changed in terms of sign. The cosecant x is nothing but reciprocal of sine function. So, the cosecant x is replaced by 1 by sine x. After that, we get the sine square x is equal to sine square alpha form. We know how to solve that one. So, let us proceed. Given 3 cosecant x equals to 4 sin x. Just observe cosecant x. Here cosecant x equals to, we know, 1 by sin x from basic trigonometric functions, one of the formulae. So, this can be written 3 by sin x or 3 over sin x, 4 sin x. Cross multiply, the 4 sin square x is equal to 3. This sin square x is equal to 3 by 4. This 3 by 4 can be written root 3 by 2 whole square. Check it. Root 3 by 2 is nothing but sine of 60 degrees. This is sin square 60. 60 means pi by 3. Now, could you just imagine what is the value of its principal value? Principal value is nothing but pi by 3. Yes. So, now the alpha is equal to principal value, that is pi by 3. Therefore, general solution is x is equal to n pi plus or minus alpha. So, n pi plus or minus pi by 3, where n belongs to z. So, in this way, we can solve the problem.